Now to something that is going to have an awful lot of traffic heading its way from next Friday. The 2018 Adelaide Fringe kicks off this Friday, and so begins 4 weeks of entertainment mayhem all over the city, and in fact all over the state, because it's in the country as well. Believe it or not, it's been running for more than 50 years and has grown to be the world's second largest festival of its type behind Edinburgh. And it is, though, the biggest festival in the Southern Hemisphere and continues to grow. And the lady in charge of it all, the lady responsible for it growing and being such a wonderful success, is the Adelaide Fringe Director and CEO, Heather Croall, and she joins me now. Hello there.
Thank you for having us on.
How are the nerves? Four sleeps to go.
It's only four sleeps to go. I'm sure that people have noticed there's fringe staff and venues all over town working around the clock to build what's going to be an amazing kickoff on Friday night.
Is this the biggest?
This will be, well, it depends what you mean by the biggest, but the biggest we normally like to measure by, you know, the audience numbers and the tickets. And at the moment, we are on track to again smash our record from last year. The last few years, we've had growth of around about 10% every year on ticket sales. And as of today, compared to this day last year, we're 8% up. So it does look like...
Who would have thunk it, hey? That's fantastic. It's tracking that well.
Yes, it's. I mean, every year we think, well, have we hit the limit? But we just don't seem to. Yeah. So we're on track to grow again. We've got venues, or you know, all over the city. We've got 1,200 shows, which involves 6,000 artists, and there's venues everywhere with the Fringe. Of course, there's the big outdoor hubs like Garden, Gluttony, the Croquet Club, but there's little venues even just downstairs from here. You walk around within a few metres. There's quite a lot of venues just around the corner, down in Hyde Street there, Rhino Room, Rajopolis. They're everywhere you look.
Exactly. It's not just focused on Rymal Park, is it, or down a Pinky Flat. Can you explain to us, I think there's a little bit of confusion out there in some people's minds, Gluttony and then the major location. We're talking about Rymal Park, sort of split into two.
Yes, so we don't run any of the venues. We are we're sort of the matchmaking service that helps artists find their venues, and we also do the ticketing for the artists, and we do all the marketing that you see all over town on every bus, tram, lamppost and everything. We don't run the venues. So the venues come to us and they say, we would like to be a fringe venue, and we're absolutely supportive of and help them. So the Garden is run by a group of people that have been running it for, you know, 20 years, or Gluttony's now 6 or so years old, and Croquet Club's, I think, in its fourth year. So they are outdoor fringe venue hubs, but they're run by people just in the same way that the Producers Hotel, for example, is a great little hub of lots of shows, and that's run by the guys at the Producers Hotel.
Right, okay. Yeah. The German Club and places
and
like that.
The German Club.
Things like
and,
that, yeah.
Yeah, almost every pub and cafe and, you know, bowls club and everything in the city.
So you're sort of the overarching organisation that keeps all of this under control.
Yes.
Do you actually put out expressions of interest for artists of certain types? Do you have any artistic control?
No, we're open platform. Yep. So we make a you know, concerted effort to make no favourites, and no, we just say we're like, in some ways it's a bit like Airbnb. You know, if you want to put your house on there, you can, and if you don't, you don't have to. If you want to put a fringe show on, you can, and if you don't want to, you don't have to.
You ever knocked back an artist as being unsuitable?
No, not in my time have we had to do that, but we're pretty much, as long as what you're doing is legal, it's okay. You can be in.
And then you can just leave it up to the audience.
Leave it up to the audience, because the audience will, word of mouth is so strong at the Adelaide Fringe, and everybody knows that a good show, the ticket sales start picking up really quickly, because the word of mouth is big on the street. We also have big social media noise in the Adelaide Fringe these days. Lots and lots of people on Facebook sharing their favourite tips and so on. And we've increased our searchability functions on the website, which people are really loving. We're getting great feedback on the new way that our website works. So while people think, well, the guide is big, and it is big, that it's true, but if you go online, you can search and you can put filters on and make, you know, suddenly suddenly the program seems much easier to navigate once you get online.
And the thing too, having a look online or the guide that was in the paper on the weekend, there's so much variety. It is so bizarre from one extreme to the other, isn't it?
And also, I think some people think, oh, it's all on at night. But actually, it's lots and lots of stuff on at the day. We even did a matinee guide this year because there's so many things on during the day. And that's great for people that don't really want to go out at night. So there's lots of stuff at the day. There's lots of stuff in the early evening. And, of course, it does go late as well. And as you say, the variety, just amazing. Mm-hmm. So, cabaret. Lots and lots of music. Music is our second biggest genre in the Fringe. So comedy's the biggest, and music, and lots of fabulous original music, but then there's great tribute bands. It's just everything. Yeah.
It is. It's something for everyone. That's a cliche, but it's really accurate in this case.
It is. I know. Yeah. I mean, as you say, it's a bit of a cliche, but it's true with the Fringe. Mm. And when people say to me, what should we see? I always just say, try something different that you wouldn't normally do. Don't just go to the same venue all the time. Go somewhere you've never heard of and give it a go. And get to meet the artist afterwards. That's the beautiful thing about Adelaide
Fringe. The meet and greet afterwards, is really important, isn't it? It's a unique part of the Fringe.
Yeah. Very rare does that happen anywhere, really, where the audience can just mingle afterwards with the artist, and it's lovely.
Friday night, opening night.
Big plans.
What are the highlights?
So we have a street party on North Terrace, and it starts at 5:00. There'll be 6 stages of different artists and musicians and all sorts on the stages, all the way from Government House, like King William Street, right up to Frome. So all the way through there's 6 different stages, lots of food trucks and, you know, all sorts of things going on, mayhem of artists roving around and New Orleans-style bands blowing their horns and things. And then at 8:00, we'll have the really beautiful sunset ceremony led by our producer, Carl Telfer. So that's the Ghana ceremony that happens on the lawns at the museum. Beautiful. Goes for around about half an hour as the sun goes down. So Tindo at Perndi is the sunset ceremony. And then as the darkness descends, the parade of light switches on, and all the projections come on the building. And this amazing one that we're really excited about called Borealis is a lasers project with haze that creates the Northern Lights effect, the curtain rippling through the sky, and that will be above the museum into the sky every single night of the Fringe.
And that's going to be stunning. Absolutely stunning.
Well, you don't need to fly all the way to Norway to get the Northern Lights. You just go to North Terrace.
And that'll be on every night there, over the museum.
And we've been able to work really closely with the Department of Transport with DIPTI on just making sure that the tram extension starts late after midnight. And, you know, that's just, I think that's great.
That was sorted, wasn't it? Because that was blown up to be a bit of a,
it's great to have a major festival and major works all together at once.
Yeah, absolutely, it is. This the other parts of the parade of light.
Yes.
Okay, so we're going to see
amazing
that. What else? All the other buildings?
There's an interactive projection on Elder Hall where you actually can control what gets on there.
Really?
And there's a beautiful one on the Mitchell Building, which will be a century of circus and fairground images and a tribute to our very own South Australian suffragette, Muriel Matters, who fought for the vote for women, and there's a lovely piece as a tribute to Muriel on that building. And then on Bonython Hall we have the fringe poster, the balloon dog, coming to life, and he's having a hard time trying to find a career that would suit him or her. And obviously goes down the road of some unsuitable careers like seamstress and, you know, pops with a needle and all this sort of thing. So that's good fun. And then the Dreaming Light, which is a stunning project made by local Kangaroo community with Yelaka dancers and local Illuminart. And that is on the South Australian Institute building. And that is a beautiful cultural and spiritual story that comes to life on the building there, and about the, you know, living culture of the Kangaroo people with the land. And it's really beautiful. So, and on the gallery, on the art gallery, they've worked with an artist called Lindy Lee. And Lindy Lee is part of the biennial this year at the art gallery. And her project is called Life of Stars. And what it is literally just the sky coming to life on the buildings, shooting stars and the planets. And oh, it's just beautiful.
Stunning. Mm. It's, you know what I like about the whole idea, and we've had the lights before, but this this is bigger than it's ever been before.
Yes, and more animated this time as well.
And that's what I was going to say. It's those majestic buildings on North Terrace, you know, our one most wonderful boulevard, probably one of the most wonderful boulevard in Australia, without doubt.
Yeah,
you've got these wonderful historic buildings which got. Who've got a real backstory, you know, Elder Hall, Bonython Hall and so forth. They've got their own story. And then you come along with a festival like this and you bring the 21st century into those buildings.
That's so good.
And it's just fantastic, isn't it?
Yeah, and as you say, there has been projections before. This is the first time we're going to be doing it for the whole month. So, you know, some people said to us last year, oh, it only went for a few days, and they got, you know, upset. And so we said, okay, we'll do it for the whole month, and that's wonderful. But it's also, I lived overseas for a long time, and when I came back and looked at that cultural boulevard with new eyes of having lived away, and I just thought, this is the most beautiful series of buildings in a promenade and an easy walk along. And it was dark most, you know, every night of the Fringe and Festival. I mean, apart from the projections that had been, you know, some years ago. So I thought, well, let's bring it to life again. And now that we've got Pinky Flat and lots of venues all over, and then we've got the East End, this is a perfect connecting corridor. So if you go and see a Fringe show, the promenade past the Parade of Light is an automatic thing to do after the show. Maybe you'll end up down at another venue and you, who knows, you might go see a late night show that you weren't planning on.
Yeah.
So, and we're also trying to create a vibe that is a lot of people milling about that artists can come down and meet and meet, you know, they can use the crowds as a sort of opportunity to spruik their show. So, you know, come and see my show tomorrow night or whatever. So it is about bringing that whole precinct to life. Yeah. That's why we're doing that. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, really good point. You know, you had the two sort of locations and nothing in between.
Nothing in
between. This solves that problem. Really well done. We're talking about The Fringe, which kicks off this Friday, goes for 4 weeks. Heather Croall is the director. She's with us. Happy to take your calls. 8223 0000. And it's 10 minutes away from 2. Tense up. Time to get very tense and get excited, because the Adelaide Fringe kicks off this Friday night. We have Heather Croall, the director and CEO of The Fringe, with us. And look, I don't know where to start in this segment talking about The Fringe. There's just so much on. What are we going to see outside of the main venues? You know, we know about Rhino Park. We know about Pinky's Flat.
Yeah. Oh, well, I mean, we have over 400 venues in the Adelaide Fringe, so they are spread all throughout the CBD. They even, you know, go out into the suburbs. We're seeing a growth in fringe venues in the suburbs, and also a lot of councils are starting to do specific activations in their area for maybe not for the whole month of Fringe, but they'll pick a weekend and they'll do something specific. We'll work with them on how to pull it all together. So we see things like Fringe popping up down at Port Adelaide for a weekend, even though there's also, by the way, a huge Fringe program down at Port Adelaide all month in lots and lots of venues. And we even see things like the airport want to do a bit of Fringe in the airport, or Westfield, all different sort of ways of presenting the Fringe. And then even reaching out into Mount Gambier, Whyalla, Port Augusta.
I was going to say, the regions, you haven't overlooked the regions, have you?
No, absolutely. And so Whyalla do theirs in Easter, so around Good Friday and Saturday. And Port Augusta does Desert Fringe, which is, I think that one's on March 3rd and 4th. So people pick the different councils pick their dates, and the first time ever we're seeing Kangaroo Island doing a Fringe activation on February the 20th.
Wonderful excuse to go to KI for the weekend.
I know, yeah. Right? Go overstay for the stay for an extra day.
Yeah, what a wonderful excuse. Not that we need an excuse. Street art explosions, well and truly big time this year.
We started it 3 years ago and it was really just about what can we do to make fringe venues look all bright and colourful during the day, because we know they look bright and colourful at night. We thought, well, let's do a map of all the street art in Adelaide so people can go on a walking tour and explore it. That first year, the map had around about 70 pieces in there, and last year we had about 100 and something. Well, this year it's completely gone through the roof. So there's almost 200 pieces of street art on that map now, because there's also the Wonder Walls down at Port Adelaide. And so we've commissioned approximately 40 or 50 street artists in the last 3 years to make beautiful murals around Adelaide. Alongside that, we've seen a growth in murals anyway. And so together, what that's all done has turned Adelaide into one of the best street art cities in the world very quickly in the last couple of years. And we've created this map because people love to go on a walking tour and just see, walk around an alley and get surprised by a huge, enormous mural up on the wall. And we've got those maps at the box office, at Rundle Mall, at East End, all of our box offices. And we're seeing them, you know, really get march out the door.
And it also shows just how connected the Fringe is with all of Adelaide, doesn't it? Really, you know.
And some of the street art is outside of their CBD. So we've commissioned works in northern suburbs, down in the southern suburbs, everywhere. So, you'd be surprised how much street art is in your neighbourhood these days. And it's some of the best in the world.
Now, some of the shows, what are some of the new events you've got on this year? New locations, new venues?
Oh, new locations. Wow. Well, the Wine Centre is a new location, which is it's got a wonderful program there. And
I'll just interrupt. We've got Keith Conlon coming in there through the week to talk about his show.
Oh, right.
Which will be a lot of fun.
And he'll be
know about the history of the unofficial history of South
Horrible
Australia.
Horrible history, yes. I saw him tweeting about it actually. Raj House has a great program. In fact, Raj House is just downstairs from here, just off Hindmarsh Square. There's next to, you know, the old bus depot on Franklin.
Yeah,
they've got the old check-in room there is now called the Joinery, and they've got some shows in there. There's even shows in swimming pools. So we've got a show in the swimming pool down on Victoria Square at the Adena, and then we've also got one at the Aquatic Centre. And in the one at the Aquatic Centre, you actually get in the pool. So as an audience member, you have to bring your own bathers.
You have to put your togs on.
Get your togs on and get your goggles on. And so if there's a heat wave, that one will be selling well. Everywhere. There's a show that's just in a caravan, which is called A Visit with Nan in a Caravan. There's one in a shipping container called Seance. And there's another, the shipping container seance one is quite spooky if you like to get spooked. But there's another shipping container actually just at the old Royal Adelaide Hospital, and it's called The Portal.
Right.
It's a golden shipping container. You'll probably see it if you've driven by. And we've got some fringe artists in there, and that portal is connected to 25 other shipping container portals around the world.
Wow.
In Germany, Afghanistan and all sorts of places. And so you can interact with the people who are in those other countries as well.
See, it just shows how widespread the fringe is.
Fringe going to the world.
Yeah, absolutely. How big do you reckon it can get? I mean, we're second only to Edinburgh.
That's right.
How different are we from Edinburgh? What makes us so special?
Well, Edinburgh and Adelaide have got a lot in common. So we're both small cities.
Yeah.
Both of our fringes completely take over, and we're walkable cities and things, lots and lots in common. Edinburgh is a bit rainy even though they do their fringe in the summer, it almost rains every day. Mm. But I mean, we have the sunshine pretty much every day, touch wood, and we have beautiful balmy, starry sky nights and fabulous. After you see a show, people linger longer out at the in the beautiful weather and so on. And I think that while we've learned a lot from Edinburgh, they've also learnt some from us, because we started the idea that there'd be these big outdoor garden style hubs. Mm-hmm. They didn't used to have those in Edinburgh. They've started them now. They do them with, it's more of an astroturf, you know, situation in a square because they haven't quite got the big, beautiful parklands of Adelaide. Yeah. But they're, you know, they're working really well in Edinburgh as well. But so I think we learn from each other. We're very, they're in the summer over there in August and we're in the summer in February, March here. So what you see is a lot of the artists that go to Edinburgh Fringe also come to Adelaide Fringe. They're sort of on this circuit with the two fringes. Mm. They sell 2 million tickets, Edinburgh, and they're tourists are making up around about 50% or more of their sales. That's our real growth area. And with the Fringe, the artists earn the money based on the box office. So our focus is always on how do we grow the ticket sales so the artist earns more money. That's our whole reason for being. And we have set ourselves a target. So last year we sold 660,000 tickets, which is amazing in itself. But we've set ourselves a really bold target of 1 million tickets by 2022. And alongside that, we've also set ourselves a target of tripling our tourist numbers to the Adelaide Fringe.
So you see that's where the growth area,
growth potential is. Yeah. So we see that the ticket sales has still got room to grow. It's just that we've got to get more tourists into Adelaide, and what a better time to come to Adelaide than the summer festivals. They can go to the festival, WOMAD, Fringe, Writers' Week, the Adelaide 500. There's so much going on that it's just a great time to sell the city.
It certainly is. All right, well, let's try to up those tickets. You got any tips for me as a consumer as far as buying tickets are concerned?
Well, there's lots of ways to save money on tickets. You can become a Fringe member. I'd probably say it's the number one tip. Lots and lots of shows offer membership 25% off. Yeah, and we also have the half ticks every day. Fringe dollars, there's lots of pubs and restaurants and places all around town who will accept Fringe dollars and give you a discount on a drink or discount on some food. BankSA supports us in so many wonderful ways. They have picked a number of shows where the ticket price will drop down to $10. They'll still pay the rest of the gap to the artist.
Oh, really?
But you'll only pay
$10. They're subsidising the tickets.
That's right. So the artist doesn't lose. They still get the full price.
Yep.
And the BankSA and Channel 9 have also done Take a Friend for Free, and that's on opening night. So jump on the phone lines and on the website and you'll see which shows are eligible for Take a Friend for Free. And group bookings of six and above often attract discounts, and there's often a cheap Tuesday price. A lot of these discounts are all decided by whether the artist opts in or we don't force the artist to do any discounting, but obviously they choose to do some because it does help their sales. But if you do join up to be a Fringe member now, it costs you $20 and you'll make that money back probably in your first booking, and you get discounts all year.
Absolutely, yeah. It's a no-brainer, isn't it? For $20.
I think it's the best membership around. Unless you guys have got one, of course. Ours is best.
Yours is. Hey, listen, all the best with it. Break a leg.
Thank you.
Not that I want to see you in a cast.
Please not.
But it all kicks off this Friday.
There usually is a Fringe artist who breaks a leg
in the
month.
Normally a little mishap somewhere, isn't there?
It's a whole month.
All kicks off on Friday for a whole month. If you can't have a look at the site online, if you can't find something that takes your interest, then I really do think you need to get out more. You agree?
Yep. You've got 31 nights, absolutely hundreds of shows on every night. There must be something there.
Yeah, absolutely. Heather Croall, director and CEO of the Adelaide Fringe. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Again, and we'll see you out and about from next Friday night.
Definitely.
Good on
you. Thanks for having us on.
No worries.